always good.
Thank you.
Yeah, he's got to have a play school program.
Hey, my camera won't stop me working.
Yeah.
Excuse me. What's happening? The camera won't stop me working. You're starting to sound like Kylie Barrett.
Present a few awards. So let's get started. Over to you, Micah.
Alright, so we get straight to them. The first award to kick off the night's evening is the Most Unchanged Since Year 7 award. And the lucky winner is...
Most Unchanged.
Naomi Kendall Hall. Next off the list is the Smoker of the Year.
Kathy Dickerson.
And the winner is, no, it's not Kathy Dickerson, it's Andrew Street.
Andrew, would you like to say a few words on the
Not at all, actually. Not at all. No. Speech. Nothing to say.
Speech, come on.
No.
He's worked hard for it. What's your favourite brand?
PJ Extras, actually.
PJ Extras.
Alright, next award is the Rod Stewart Do You Think I'm Sexy Award. And the winner is...
Daniel Allen.
Sexy? Is he sexy?
Oh yeah.
Have you got it?
I don't know, babe.
What do you think, Daniel? Have you got it?
Go on.
He's got it. He thinks he's got it.
I don't know what this one means, but anyway, the Ginger Rogers Award.
Dance. Dances?
Oh, this is for like groovy dances, I think. Oh. And the winner is Amphis in Pursuit.
You should be dancing. That's a beautiful.
Right, the next award is the Mr. America Award.
And the winner is Stuart Shanks.
Thanks, guys.
You want to see?
Yeah, go on. Tell us.
Thanks, guys.
I like the heavy breathing. It's good.
The I'm So Tough I Could Rust Award.
That's Pete! Pete Carroll! Pete's not here, so where? No one's going to come and get it.
Where?
He's too tough to come in.
Now we've got the Most Changed Since Year 7 award.
Danny Rodrigo.
The next award is the Valentine Award.
And the winner is Lauren Babula. Most individual style.
And I think she knows who she is, it's Amy Malthus.
Representing New Zealand tonight. Just the way she walks is so individual.
The next award is the Fred Astaire Award. And this is for dancing as well. All these dancers.
I hope it's Chris, I hope it's Chris.
Only Anton Coppola.
Chris, you missed it. How did you miss it? He's a shattered man.
It hurts deep down inside, but...
Do you want to basically take him on?
Do you want to dance? I'm just
Was Chris B close?
Chris B, he had to be.
Yeah, runner up, Chris B. Shattered man. Well, what do you got to say, Chris? How are you going to live with this?
That was it. That was all you had a chance of.
I know.
David Hayes!
Dave, I missed
that's
the award.
The first half of our
class
clown. Our awards.
Class what?
Class clown. Everyone can enjoy their meal for a while, and we'll get the other half time later.
What I've done is organise food jokes to start off with on the table, and there's some money through the bar available for extra jugs if you want them. That money will run out reasonably shortly. And after that...
This person is very impressive. What's his name again? Okay, Andrew. Currently, how many cigarettes do you get in between 9 o'clock and 3:20? On an average day?
10.
10. That's a record.
On rainy days it goes up, doesn't it? What?
On rainy days you can get a few more in?
Yeah, it's a bit harder because the smoke seems to come out, pour it out because of this.
It tends to hang around a bit.
Yeah.
Like, over 4 years, how many times have you been busted?
Twice.
Who are the teachers?
Mr. Langdon.
Yeah.
And Mrs. Davies.
Right. And apparently, which is the best place in the school? You can give it away now. You're just about finished. What's the best place to do it?
On the oval.
The oval's the easiest.
Yeah, the oval would be the easiest.
All right.
Actually, the basketball courts and the oval are pretty even.
Are they?
Yeah, because you sit up under the trees there.
Right.
Easy.
Okay, well, Andrew, you're not far behind. How many did you get in between 9 and 3?
Two, mate.
Two.
Yeah, you're up there every time I'm
off. And I have one in the morning and then one at school to about 5 at school usually.
You guys keep Benson and Hector's alive.
When I go to school.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of motorbikes, I got onto Ben's four-wheeler the other day. I just went off my jump. That's right. Yeah.
Tell him how you crashed into your house.
I crashed into my house, eh, Tom?
Yeah?
Yeah. I was like 80 k's, went over and jumped reverse and towards the house. Oh, yeah, And,
this boy, he's got manners. Girls, aren't you just so pleased you brought him? Who brought this guy?
She asked me.
I bring him.
She asked me.
Thanks, Burb Hughes. I'll get over and see Matt Hill about it.
Yeah, he can jump his house and jump dams and right up trees.
Ask Sam Boyd about the cops. They're always...
Get your hand off him like that.
It's a Vanderbilt.
Who told you that?
Just been asked to come over and talk to you. What can you do on a motorbike that's just unheard of?
Oh, I can attempt to ride up trees about a metre.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. Do all sorts of stuff.
So, Someone mentioned the fact that you could actually jump a house. Is this
That's bullshit.
That's bullshit. Okay. But what have you jumped?
What have I jumped on? Fences? Nah, I haven't jumped fences. Just normal jumps and shit.
Okay. Well, someone's obviously pulling your leg.
They must be pulling it hard.
Hills without hotel.
Jake threw a glass at me because
there it is.
You ever wonder?
He threw a glass of cake on me because I was
going to
throw a glass of cake at him because.
Oh, really?
He was being a smarter.
Yeah, I was being a smarter. So just,
and you just got what you deserved.
Yeah, exactly.
Look at that. What a gleam! And who would choose like this?
Dude, airing them, sir. I want to know how you get them like that.
That's a good summer! Excellent.
The hair matches his suit.
Yeah,
new hair.
I tell you what, ever since you've got it, you took the prize.
The best shoes
in the house. We've been comparing. The boys have been comparing. You win the prize.
Look at these.
Say that you win it.
They are daggers. They've got no statement at all, but they could get up and walk on their own.
They could indeed.
That's better than the 70s. What's that?
That's glitz.
That's glitz.
Yes.
Yeah, but they're hot. Look at that. Who do they belong to? The girl from the 1970s.
And I'm looking into you.
Right, let's have a look at this. What can you do, Andrew?
It's a bracelet.
Hey!
I'm having another party next year, but this time I'm organising it.
Another party?
Yeah, and I'm going to tell my parents.
Why did you have to play it with me at the front?
And the police aren't going to come?
Are you embarrassed?
Yes, with short hair.
Oh, short hair.
No braces yet. And the police aren't coming to Donna's party.
And it was really bad. And
not this
you
time.
Didn't have to play it.
Not this time.
No more. I've had enough.
We had
to.
Here it is. This is the scandal of the century.
I think he's a user.
This guy is a user. Girls, if you see this man anywhere on the street, he's had her. Everybody.
Me again.
She wants to be used, apparently. Use me, abuse
me.
This girl can get to Hollywood.
She's got the right nose for it.
Swept her off her feet.
Yeah, man. You're coming out with some pretty good
stuff. We're man-hating lesbians.
Are you?
Yeah, but I'm joining in.
A triad. Let's get married. Sorry, what was the award?
The cutest couple award.
The cutest couple award. Brooke Poulos and Heath Pine.
If looks could kill.
Give them me. Okay. You must smile for that one.
I'd like to thank the bridesmaids.
Yeah, thanks.
What a typical Aussie.
Together.
that's the problem. Heterosexuals aren't popular anymore at all.
Okay, next award is for the best dressed female on the night. And the winner is... Sarah McGregor! Next up's the Best Dressed Male Award, and that goes to... Oh,
damn.
Mark Bowie!
How do you feel, Mark?
Pretty good, thanks.
Pretty good?
Yeah, no fear.
My vote was in there for you.
Thanks, sir.
Next up is the Funniest Guy in Our Year Award, and that goes to... Everyone knows who it is. Come on, Sam.
Thanks, Pete. If I knew I was getting this, I would have thought of something funny to say. But I didn't, so I'll sing as a song.
Next team. Next award for the best Eagles. It goes to Robin Bowers.
Why not?
So. You're right, eh?
We drew a blank.
Well, make it up.
All right. The next one is the Longest Hair of a Male Award. If you need to go, stand up.
My son was cheating.
Sorry, come in. Come
in. This is where Dave and Vicky work. Award is the Mother Hen Award, and I think we all know that there's only one lady in this room old enough to receive.
Absolutely that. Right!
I don't think I live by both of my eyes.
How do we do this one? How do we do this one? That blank, just make it up. Oh. Just give it to Adam.
Kennedy Optimistic Award. Mr. McGowan.
And our last award for the evening is the Fabio Award. And that goes to
Bo Franklin.
And he only won it because of his shoes.
I'd just like to thank a few friends. Would you just like to come on up? Ben, you know, without him, this couldn't be possible. I'd just like to thank Simon, mate. He's been a good friend throughout the years. You know, the support's really helped. Josh, you know, come up, mate. He's been good, you know. I've known him since primary school. Sean Lane, Todd Stevens, you know, he's built. Come on up.
This is your award, fellas.
Thanks,
man.
That Pungie, I wouldn't have survived a couple of times out there in the scrub.
This is our scout, man, and we don't go anywhere without Pungy, because if we get lost, he gets us out of it.
It
sets up flies.
Is there anybody else who wants to come up?
Oh, you guys, you come up to Just everyone come up.
Come on.
It's all been good.
No, Fabio is a lover of women, not men.
For you, your first 4 years of your going on here with his soul, and that we should also. So, just to be honest, I'm very happy. I hope you've had a great night, and you're certainly still feel very, very proud of yourselves. Please don't feel very proud of you.
Thank you.
On behalf of the year and Mr. McGowan and everyone else, we'd just like to thank Mrs. Stroud for helping us, because without her we couldn't have done it.
Thank you.